I am indebted to you for your help in Latria. Without it, I would not have made it back. Now, I can go on with my work. And for that, thank you. What is it? I have no business with you. Not yet. Do not be concerned. Life is hardly as precious as one might think.
Thank you, kind soul. Please, take this fine piece of work. I have no use for it now. And thus begins my final, eternal rest. And thus begins my final, eternal rest.
Hello. I'm here to please. What can I get you? There's somebody I ought to warn you about. A fella who lacks common decency. They call him Patches the Hyena. And he's the one that laid that trap for me. He's the kind of person who'd stab his own mother in the back. If you happen to spot him, you'd do us all a favour by putting him out of his misery. Have you been to the altar where the Reapers summon shadows? Well, I think someone may be trapped in the lower cavity. I heard them praying for dear life. Pity the poor fool. He probably fell for one of Patch's old tricks. Pity the poor fool. But a bit of indulgence goes a long way.
Hello again. Hey, don't turn a cold shoulder. I didn't mean to do you wrong, really. Come on now. We've got better things to fret about. That pit there is filled with treasure. But I'm having a little trouble getting to it myself. Go on, take a look. There are more riches than you could dream of. What's keeping you? Have a look at that treasure down in the pit. Then we'll think up a way to fish it out.
I'll sell every last trinket off your corpse.
Heavens, did you fall for that little devil's trap? Well, I did the same. He fooled me, and now I am stuck here. The reverberation seemed to suggest that we are connected to the outside. A fearsome dark phantom stands between us and freedom. But have no fear. God will cleanse us of evil. Pray with me. Umbasa. Heavens. Well, pray with Umbasa. it's you. Did you cleanse the world of the aforementioned phantom? God has chosen you. And for that we are thankful, Umbasa.
Gotta make a living, right? Here, look, I can make up for it. There aren't many humans like us. We need to stick together. I know. Have this as a token of my friendship. Not bad, right? Come on. Let's be friends. What do you say? No need to drag each other down.
The Lord has not forgotten me yet, for he has allowed me into the presence of Saint Urbain. I shall serve him and pray with him, and thus express my faith in God, M'Basa. I plan to bequeath all my possessions to Saint Urbain. My grandfather's articles may contain more miracle stone shards like the one he gave me, but they'd only be wasted in my hands. Saint Urbain can hear the voice of God through them. Oh, I can hardly believe it. The fact that I'm helping to save the world. Oh, Saint Urbain, M'Basa.
My, you have rescued his Augustus. I express my deepest gratitude. You have relieved me of a great illness.
Oh, thank God.
M'Basa. With His Holiness Saint Urbain back, the magicians will have to watch themselves. Thanks to his holy miracles, you brave battlers of demons will no longer be solely dependent on dark magic. Isn't it wonderful? Surely the Demon Slayers have awaited such an opportunity. Do you have any connection to Patches the Hyena?
I trust not. He is a depraved, vile man, and he deserves no allies. I hope that an upstanding hero such as yourself is selective when making associations. By the way, I highly recommend the companionship of the jovial Saint Urbain. Have you heard the rumors about Astraea of the Valley of Defilement? They claim that she and her loyal knight have become demons and lead a clan of degenerate miscreants. In truth, the rumors are surely unfounded. There are all sorts of wrongdoers down there who would think up such nonsense. Yet, if the rumors are true, then may she be eternally damned for her debasement of the Lord's name. Yet, if the... Then may she be eternally...
Thanks to you, I was able to seek refuge in this nexus. Now I stay here and pray, along with my disciples, for the heroes facing the demons. If you wish for benevolent protection in your fight against the demons, then bring me demon souls. I will cleanse them and create miracles with their power. Astraea of the Valley of Defilement. The last I heard, Saint Astraea of the West was accompanied by the knight Garl Vinland. She would never be corrupted by souls. Not under the protection of such a renowned knight in his charmed armor. Surely, it is mere slander. Sadly, the weak are prone to such backstabbing. Vito the Moonlight Knight, Rezaya of Istarel, even Selen Vinland. Many honorable knights have ventured into Boletaria in search of the Valley of Defilement. The vicious rumors about Astraea offend our most basic sense of respect for God's name. However, none of these great knights have made it back. Could it be that that wretched valley is so infested with grime that even our Lord's voice does not resonate there? Or perhaps it is the fate of those left behind by God. If you truly are a disciple, then you must have a talisman in God's image. Heavenly miracles occur in Boletaria through the talismans. God has granted this accursed land a special power. It is God's way of telling us we must stand against the demons. Bless this brave Mbasa.
Oh, Saint Mbasa.
Oh! I seek a keepsake of my father. Have you seen the sword inscribed Makoto? I will offer you demon swords if you can help me find it. The Makoto chooses its master. But be warned. The Makoto is no sword for the faint of heart. The Makoto chooses its... But be warned, the Makoto is no sword...